made from the Eurostat in order to better implement social, regional, and other cohesion policies. There are three different divisions. The nuts that you see does not refer to the actually the thing that we eat. It's an acronym for national nomenclature for territorial units for statistics, which means we divide Europe in several smaller chunks, so we bet
diagnosis for local problems, and it comprises of 1,348 territories. Also, and just to bore you a little bit more with numbers, there is another subdivision called the local authority units, and we have 120,000 of them throughout Europe. What is it to encourage the culture of subsidiarity? What is subsidiarity? Subsidiarity is a principle where we say that it's better for a European policy to take place to the closest unit to the citizen. That is, if something can be done from your local council, it's better to be done by your local council instead of being managed from Brussels, which is, you know, more tedious and more, and the distance between us may not be as effective. And then better in our legislative process and actually do things that are better for the citizen of the EU. The COR is comprised of 350 members. They come from all countries. The number of people from different countries are
people go according to the agenda. The agenda of the groups are most close to the agenda they used when they were elected. So we have the PES, which is the Socialists, ALDE, which is Liberals, European Alliance, which is Leftists, EPP, which is Christian Democrats, the ECR, and there, which is Conservatives and the Reformists.
In the formulation of many of these policies, we have given our opinion, we have tried to make it more relevant to the territories and the localities and cities. And we will continue to closely monitor the social pillar and try to make it work for all European citizens. And now I would like to pass the talks to my colleague, who's going to talk to you about Erasmus Plus, which is his main area of expertise.
But maybe in Parliament, as we have here in Belgium. So they are in touch with the European citizens, so they bring this experience to the European level, so the voice is heard. Then another feature of the committee is this building that you are in, so it's a meeting place. And members from different European regions, cities, they meet together, they exchange best practices, and a bit outside the scope, we had a conference on football 2 days ago, and we had mayor showing how they managed to get the kids to do sport instead of hanging on the streets. And this has spillover effects in terms of integration, in terms of improving results in schools, because it was an interesting example that kids were doing their homework in the sport equipment. So they did the link, so if they do good in sports, they would also need to do good in classroom. And this is reinforcing incentive to perform better. And also I worked some years ago with the president of region of Tuscany in Italy, and they have there, I think if I remember correctly, a program, it's called Giovanni C. You are from Italy, okay. So it's like youth, yes, something like this in rough translation. And this program was designed to give a sum of money, like 500 euros. So they were paying young people to do traineeship in a company. So you can imagine this was like win-win situation. The youngsters, they get hands-on experience. The company would have some help without paying. And for the region was good, because then these young people will get employment and bring taxes, instead of getting the social benefits, like we are unemployed, they do something and they learn and build up their career. So that's an example how the COR could help, and this could be picked up by the other regional actors, by the Commission to suggest, and the rapporteur calculate.
International studies, so to do at schools.
Mm-hmm. Okay, enough. Any questions would like to check in?
European strategy about young employment for the future.
Mm. As I can tell, first of all, I have to say that ourselves are only legislative unit, which means we cannot actually force decision to be taken. What we can do at the Committee of the Regions is make a proposal and say we think that this way of going is probably the best for us. As far as I can tell, there is in the works a new project from our president called the Alliance for Skills and Education, which in its core is to implement to empower young people by making them more skills, more relevant skills for the future job market. That is, we take into consideration that there are new ways and new forms of employment, which is, for example, just a few years ago, there have been new forms of employment, such as employment on demand, for example, like Uber. That is, we are trying to take all that into consideration and make proposals that will empower people to find skills that will be better, that will better prepare them for the job market of the future. Also, the European institutions provide quite a lot of funding still, and as far as I understand from the European Social Fund Plus, this amount is going to be increased in order to create job opportunities in the member states so more people can find jobs. There are many territories that have taken advantage of it, have taken funding. Basically, more of it is co-funding between the national authority and the European Union, so as to create more job opportunities for people in various countries. As far as I understand, this is going to continue until 2017. This is the plan. But I honestly cannot give you more concrete examples, because as you probably know, in 2019, in May, there will be a new election, probably there will be a new commission, so we really are a little bit in the dark about their will and what they are going to implement.
Do the school easily get information about job opportunities, university opportunities in the different regions? Mm-hmm. So we are wondering if you here in the CR know about some projects or in this way, or if you think that the local authorities would be the right persons to speak about, because you talked about spillover effects.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it would be necessary to get some kind of network, because after several months, normally our students are really frustrated and they leave at home and they study law and rights in the next university to their home. I think it's...
Yes, it's a pity not to use the opportunity of mobility for studying and also working. Mm-hmm. I agree with you. Yes, I think, I mean, you'll learn more this afternoon, but there are many tools developed by Commission, starting with Europass and then also, there is a website where you can find the vacancies in all member states. But of course, it's the wealth of information and things can be always improved. So thank you for the project. That will be interesting to see. Well, how long is it? You have a conclusion at the end or for your project?
We'll try to end in 2 years.
Oh, 2 years. Okay.
We start. We just started now.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And I think it's a very good idea. Yes. And also with Discover EU, it's another opportunity to, because our intention was not only to travel by train for people, but to travel with a meaning. This year is the European Year of Cultural Heritage, so they can visit some cultural heritage sites in a specific region, but why not visiting the company and see how they work and if there is a place for them to, yeah, so this could be another feature of the Discover EU program.